Good morning, everybody. It is October 27th, Wednesday. It's 8:15 in the morning. I was going to do it about an hour ago. Then the dogs woke up and they were kind of going crazy. So I've been out in the yard with them, running around and playing with them and getting their breakfast ready. Let's see. What's up? What's up here? One thing, it happened yesterday. I try to be a patient person. You know, I don't expect people to follow my advice on things. So the only thing I ever encourage people to do is investigate and find your own answers and follow your own path. I just try to encourage people to do that. And on my post yesterday, where I started the post off saying that I went and got my Moderna booster shot, and I'm thrilled about it. I mean, to me, any protection for me and the people around me and my community is good. I was a science major in school, and I deeply believe in science, but one of the very first responses I had on my page, and that was just a little thing. I said I got my Moderna shot, and then I went on with the music for yesterday with James Taylor, and one of the very first comments that I got after I posted it was, there was this guy, I'm not going to say his name, but he goes, so you won a fucking gold star, you know, for your first comment? And then I went back and looked at his history, and he said some incredibly snide things throughout all my videos, about 26 comments, you know, and so I blocked him. I'm weary of that. I don't block people because we have a difference of opinion. I mean, I think that's what kind of makes the world what it is people having differences of opinion, but being able to sit and discuss them reasonably with some kind of an educated response that's based in facts and not nonsense. But when these people come on and they start just attacking like that, I have no patience. I don't want to darken my page with that kind of stuff. So he's gone. In Facebook land, I've blocked lots of people on that because I would get death threats from people saying, we know your touring schedule, we're going to come get you, and stuff like this, and really vicious people. And for me, it's just, boy, I don't have time for that. So I just block them. But it really, I have to be pushed. I'm like something in the wind, you know, that's blowing, and you bend as far as you can, but at some point you snap. So that's my little bit of a rant for today on that. But I just removed his comment because I thought it was completely out of place, and it's not even wanted to have a discussion about it. It was just strictly attacking, and it's just crazy. And it's a funny world we live in. And then, okay, so tomorrow, Danny Korchmar and Russ Kunkel and I jump on a plane and we fly to Cleveland to be a part of Carole King's induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. We are going to perform with her on that show. And I don't know when that gets aired or anything, but we'll be doing that. We fly in tomorrow, rehearse on Friday, and do the show on Saturday. And then 7 a.m. flight home on Sunday. Oh, God. But that gives me a full day at home, which is good, rather than sitting around. And it'll be interesting. I've seen the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame from a distance, but I've never been there. So it'll be real interesting to see what this is all about, and see who's see who I know, and say hi to some people, and then get the heck out of Dodge. And then we're getting ready next week to start preparing for our little mini tour with the immediate family. Some really cool things happening with the NFTs based on my book and some other things that are going on with it. But there are some alliances forming that really look like they are potentially pretty amazing. So I'm excited about that. But let's get on to music. Having discovered this other site now, this West Coast site, what is this called? La Bible de la West Coast, I think, is what it's called, from Cool Night. has a whole bunch of stuff I've been looking for ages or didn't even know about. And so I'm finding, I mean, at this rate, I should be doing this now for probably at least several more years as I discover more and more projects that I've worked on, some that I knew about and aren't showing up in some of the traditional places, and then others that it's just, this is a pretty comprehensive site, so I'm totally digging it. And the artist I'm going to go to today is the incredible Steve Wariner. Now, one of the things that's been great about all working, especially with country artists, is some of the artists are such great musicians on top of it. I mean, there's a lot of times in pop music where I've worked with people and they really don't have anything to contribute except maybe the vocal and stuff. But some of the country artists I've worked with could be standalone studio musicians on their own. And Steve is one of them as a guitarist. Vince Gill is like that. Vince is on par with all the great guitar players I've ever worked with. There's a number of them. And the first time I worked with Steve was doing this album called I Should Be With You is the title of the album. And we cut this in 1988. The great Jimmy Bowen, who got me to Nashville in the first place, and Steve produced this. Ron Treat engineered the album. This was one of the first projects I did with the wonderful Jesse Noble, who's one of the best project coordinators I ever worked with. She did all of Jimmy's projects, and Tony Brown, and so many of the producers down there. Jesse was like the person that got this all together. But we cut it at Soundstage Studios, and did a lot of projects with Jimmy at Soundstage. Soundstage is where I did the Lyle Lovett Large Band album, and that was the first time I ever had the pleasure of working with Lyle, and that was amazing. But I'm going to go ahead and play a few songs of it. Steve had has had a really extensive career. He's a fascinating artist. And once again, you know, once in a while I would, you know, start to read things about the artist. But I think if you find the music good, it's fun for you to go and dig them up and just read about them at your leisure or leisure. And see what they're all about as people. Because I one thing I didn't know, I was reading about Steve, and one of the things that he loves is magic, and he would sometimes try to get magicians to be opening acts on his show, and he became a watercolor painter and things like that. So everybody has, it's kind of like, you know, eating an artichoke or peeling an onion. You know, there's all these layers, and as you dig in, you find more and more stuff going on. So I really find it interesting to dig into these artists and see the ebb and flow of their careers, where they're like really high at one point and then suddenly it slows down for them for a while, and then they maybe go on and do something else, and then they manage to get a song that hits on the charts, and boom, they're back up there again. So it's a fascinating thing. But I'm going to go ahead and play a couple of songs from this album. It's really good, and it's a fabulous band on these things. I've got my dare I say, I've sketched up my copious notes for this morning. The first song I'm going to do is called Lights Out. And this was written by Dave Loggins and Don Schlitz. Now, I've worked with Dave Loggins, and one of the last shows that we did at the Library of Congress for ASCAP called We Write the Songs, where they bring in different songwriters to talk about their songwriting process, and I'm part of the house band that plays with all these artists, and there's usually six or eight artists on it. Don Schlitz, who co-wrote this, was one of the people who came in, and he wrote The Gambler for Kenny Rogers. Now, Kenny did a great job on it, but it was almost like a novelty tune, the way it was done. And when we did this with Don at the Library of Congress, boy, did I come up with an entire new respect for this song. His performance of it was deep, and we were all kind of looking at each other going, holy crap, this is really an amazing piece of material. He sold it in a way that I had never heard before. Now, the band on this is, it's pretty much the same band with a few additions on different songs throughout the project, but it's myself and my buddy Russ Kunkel, Steve Wariner on guitar, Billy Joe Walker Jr. on guitar, and Reggie Young on guitar. Now, so many of the projects I did in Nashville had Billy Joe Walker Jr. and Reggie Young both on guitar. They were a remarkable team together. There was this fit when those two guys played. And it breaks my heart that they're no longer with us, but amazing. And then on keyboards, we have Billy Payne from Little Feet, who also toured with James Taylor. We spent a lot of time on the road together. And the background vocalists on this are Mac McAnally and Wendy Waldman, which is a pretty damn good background vocal section. So here's Lights Out, Steve Wariner from 1988. But it feels very kind of like Hall & Oates could have done that. Here's a song called More Than Enough, and this is a song written by Jimmy Webb. And this is, again, myself and Russ and Steve Wariner on acoustic guitars and Billy Joe Walker Jr. and Reggie Young on electric. The great Mark O'Connor on fiddle and mandolin. And the background vocal on this is Glenn Campbell. So here we go. More Than Enough. Thank you.
slips my mind, but you forget and never even ask me why. The sweetness is in short supply. You give me more than enough to just get by, more than enough to satisfy. Money's scarce and times get rough. You know you still got a tough love. My heart away when everything I need is with you. Tomorrow, now, and yesterday, my blessings seem to multiply. You give me more than enough to just get by, more than enough to satisfy. Yes, we got more than enough to just get by, more than enough to testify. The world is cold and it calls your blood. You know you still got a tough love. You give me more than enough love. You know we still got a tough love. You give me more than enough love. You know you still
good stuff, straight up. Boy, it's really good, but I just found him really great. I wish we would have had an opportunity to do more projects together. And there's a bunch of good songs on this album. I'm just playing a couple of them here, but it's a really, really good album. And remember, it's called I Should Be With You from 1988, Steve Wariner. Now here's a track called Baby, I'm Yours. And this was written by Guy Clark and Steve Wariner. And this one is myself and Russ Kunkel, Billy Joe Walker Jr. on acoustic guitar, Reggie Young and Steve Wariner on electric, and the solo is by Steve and Billy Payne on piano. So here we go. This is Baby, I'm Yours. Steve.
There's nothing in the world I wouldn't do for you. It thrills me when I think that you feel the same way too. I must be dreaming. Baby, I'm yours, heart and soul. Baby, I'm yours till we both grow old. What you want. I've been around the world and I've had my share, just about everything there is, but I swear it just don't mean nothing. The grass is always greener on the other side. Whoever said that never did look into your eyes. I have your loving. Baby, I'm yours, heart and soul. Baby, I'm yours till we both grow. Baby, I'm yours, does it do with me what you want?
always love doing ends with Russ. Yeah, Russ has a very signature end of songs and buttons. It's really great. One last song for you here. This is called Runnin'. And this was written by Steve Wariner and Wendy Waldman. And this is myself and Russ Kunkel, Steve Wariner on acoustic, Reggie Young and Billy Joe Walker Jr. on electrics. The solo is Steve again and Billy Payne on keys. And the background vocals on this are Steve Wariner, Mac McAnally, and Wendy Waldman. So after this is just four tunes. There's like a dozen songs on this record, and they're all really great songs. So if you want, check it out. Just dig Steve. So here we go, one last song, and then a little yak, and then I'm off and running. It's called Runnin'.
You look so pretty. A country girl alone in New York City. Well, you got your big break doing what you wanna do. If I could do what I wanted, I'd be right with you.
Russ is so good at creating parts on
now
drums.
I know I wanna
orchestral.
Make you mine. I'm gonna get you by my side, it's a matter of time. Love don't come easy, it's hard to understand. And it won't work out until you make your stand. You keep running. Like the taxis in the street, like vintage wine, like the rivers back home that run so free, run anywhere you want, but baby, run to me. Taxis in the street, like vintage wine, like the rivers back home. And run so free, run anywhere you want. But baby, run to me.
So that's it, a taste of Steve Wariner from 1988. I'm just digging rehearing all these things. There's so many things I've been discovering that I completely have not heard in so long. that it's really, it's a trip. You know, I actually did something. I can't believe it. I'm going to get running here. And as the song said, I've got a dentist appointment today and stuff like that. And I've got to go pick up some more artwork from Blue to mail off of prints that were ordered of my artwork. And just always, it's always stuff going on, which I'm grateful for. I'm not a good person with downtime. And so I'm going to go take care of that. And let me see. And then so get ready for tomorrow to head off to Cleveland. That should be an interesting event. You know, it'll be fun just to see what the hell this thing is really all about. So maybe I should wear a T-shirt that says "Why isn't Zevon here in here?" There's such a push all the time for Warren Zevon to have been in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame because his contributions are so unique. But a lot of this stuff, I don't know how decisions are made, but that's got nothing to do with my life. Players like me have really very little to do, ultimately, with the music business. We're just the gardeners that, you know, and the plumbers. That's it. So that's it. I'm going to get going here. I'm going to wish everybody a wonderful kind of middle of the week. And again, I was grateful to be able, especially before a bunch of traveling coming up, to get my booster shot. And it's not a political statement. I'm talking about health and well-being and being around my family and friends and community and not being somebody who can potentially cause grief for others around me. And that's it. And I encourage you to do the same, but it's up to you. Don't come back on this and go crazy. And again, thank you so much. Boy, every day I see interviews with medical, especially workers, that just, boy, they are still under so much duress over this whole thing. And I really feel for them. You know, their families have suffered so much because, you know, so many of them, even when they're not working, they can't come home. You know, they've got to still be in quarantine and stuff. It's just, it's crazy. So, just best to everybody out there and your families. I had fun yesterday. I had a couple of cameo orders for birthdays, so I sent off birthday wishes to people, and that was fun. And I'll have more info about the NFTs. I'm going to have a meeting tonight. I've got an interview at noon today before I leave for the dentist, and then I'm going to meet with Jared tonight, who's the brains behind this NFT campaign. He's just a brilliant cat. And we're going to organize some more things. So there's lots of stuff going on. It's kind of blows my mind that at this point, this in my life, there's this much stuff happening. But I'm grateful for it. So take good care, and I will see you tomorrow. I'll get something off to you, and then I will be heading to the airport and in transit for a chunk of the day. Now, I'll try to see if it's possible to film any stuff and post it from the event. I'm not sure what their security is with cameras and all that, but we'll find out. So take good care, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.